gone on and off over the years, you know. I mean, it's like, you know, when we started, it was very intense. We were on a crest of a wave. We just like, we were like into a whole new land. I mean, the whole music industry was in a whole new different wave of thinking, a new energy of music that just came about almost overnight. And people just rolled with it. It was breaking the laws, this stuff, you know. It was a very different land. Then it got regulated and everything, and things got like segregated and put into genres, and we kind of like, you know, kind of, I don't know, just drifted off, and we've kind of come in and out of focus of this.
Actually just gone back to analog. We spent last probably 10 years doing digital, and then Nigel got a bit in his bonnet about taking it back to where it was.
There's a total different sound about, you know, I mean, you know, when you're traveling, it's very difficult to import, like, over, like, you're flying with Ryanair, you can't take a Juno 60 with you, so you got to like scale it down to like where you're going, but you can sample the sound of those keyboards, keep it very analog, and then you can trigger those sounds in a digital way to make it happen live. So it's fluid like live, but it's got the analog sound with it.
This little scene, which fortunately we were part of, we probably won't see the end of it in our life.
So I've got a 17-year-old son who's like, he's going out now, he's hitting the V Festival, he's like going out, he's big on it, he's going out on every single thing.
And just like his dad.
Just like that one. But he comes back playing the stuff and I'm going, I love this. And what is it? It's like house and it's like rave sounds and it's like rocking and the kids are going mental to it.
Thank you.
you know what, now it's become like consolidated right into a proper vintage kind of, you can't touch this now, it's gold.
The rave scene is built on that anyway. It's like here, I've gone out in the crowd and spent an hour out there because it's nice just bumping into people. Thank you for coming over, and it's nice to give, you know, like, just get involved with people, because it's all about a unity of, you know, everyone being together as one.
Polish Ultra Festival! Warming you up for an all-night session. It's ready to wait till 7.
Going back to, say, 93, when we was doing a lot of PAs, we had a sticker battle with Prodigy, and everywhere the Prodigy had been, they were sticking stickers up everywhere, and we was peeling them off and sticking our stickers up there. And we still do stickering now today.
Prodigy, really, that was my first musical experience from back then when I was younger. The experience when the album came out in 92, I bought the tape, and that's what I listened to when it first came out. I was at Labyrinth once, and MC Ruff, who was MCing it there at the time, put the mic down on the side and went to the toilet. And I just looked at it and I picked it up and I went, oi, oi. And because it was a new voice in the crowd that nobody had heard before, everybody kind of turned around and it was me. And I didn't have many lyrics back then.
It's your party, it's your time.
But then as I built, I learned more lyrics and became stronger.
How's that? How you feeling out there? Are you having a good time? Nah, that was rubbish. Are you having a good time? Big up the Woods Massive. And it's the last one.
It's a really good crowd though over the weekend. It's been buzzing. Totally, yeah.
Yeah. Last one, the Fat Controller.
It's strange, you come into a different country, okay, there's different cultures, but it's all just one love of music. Everyone just absolutely loved it. That's why I've been so looking forward to coming back again this year.
Thank you. like Delight, I like Bjork when she used to be in the Sugar Cubes. I like a lot of old school hip hop, like Run DMC, LL2J. That's what I was brought up on. So I'm into that type of music, reggae as well. But like the rave scene was new at the time and I just happened to be at the right place at the right time to get into it. But I did the old school in the 90s. I was a teenager then. And then, you know, I moved to Munich, Germany, did other stuff. And then I've been in like a band, Stereo MCs, for like about 9-10 years, touring the world. But I also did a lot of rave now and again, because I know a few people. So it's nice just coming back and just doing some rave stuff, because the people really, really appreciate it. I never knew it was so big here in Poland. When I started doing it, everybody was always, it was very enthusiastic. It was a new style of music. It was like we was right at the beginning of it. And so I find it always quite interesting that people still love this type of music. It astonishes me, because it's been like 20 years since I did that first song.
A scratch DJ, and I was into kind of hip hop and early hip hop, and used to listen to a guy called Mike Allen on Capital Radio. He used to do his Frontline chart, which was the only place you could listen to hip hop in the UK in the early 80s. And so we'd sort of copy mixtapes and stuff like that, and then I got into buying vinyl when it came into London for the first time at Groove Records and places like that. Got into mixing and scratching, and then I had a show on a pirate station in Luton, and played a couple of demos and met a guy, and that's how I sort of got signed up for my first ever track, which was a track called The Terminator, which I think was in kind of 1990. I loved it, yeah, absolutely loved it. The Polish crowd is amazing. It's like going back 20 years in the UK. The Polish ravers really know how to have a good time.
As hardcore disappears, it evolves. Happy hardcore, drum and bass, trance came along, garage came along. We still love the old school. So at a point, we decided, let's not make a drum and bass tune, let's make a new track that sounds like 1992. And we started doing that, and
we were making these new tracks that sounded like they were old. And I gave Slipmat a copy of one of them. He started playing it. So once Slipmat was playing our track in his sets, people became aware of this track and looking out for more Damage Inc. tracks. Crowds always deliver, don't they? And Woods has got to be the number one rave capital in the world.
One place. Zapraszamy One Place na scenę. Słuchajcie, ten oto człowiek jest jednym z najlepszych producentów muzyki elektronicznej, połamanych bitów w Polsce. One Place!
Yeah.
seen over the years coming here, everything is getting bigger and bigger every year. Look at the lineup. The lineup speaks for itself. It's legends after legends of UK international artists, and of course, the Polish legends. You have One Place, you have Greg Sinkay, jungle drummer, amazing with Rosella tonight. Everybody, you feel good. Everybody,
feel good. Let me see you move your hands in the air.
The time anybody really noticed what I was doing was the video that made me famous, which was me playing at somebody's house party in Leeds in the UK. And I just did it for a laugh, but the video of it went viral instantly, and we've actually just 2 weeks ago topped 500,000 views. I went to the original Blackburn raves in like late 89, early 1990, all the warehouse parties in the UK. And I mean, when something like that bites you, you're bitten for good. And so when the old school resurgence started happening in the UK about maybe 8 years ago, we jumped on, we put a few nights together, and it proliferated really quickly and went countrywide. And even now, well, we were talking sort of 8 years after the first night we put on, there are still hundreds of old school nights all over the UK. People that you find on the scene are very down to earth as well. They've not got sort of big star attitudes. They're just guys who love the music.
From this so long, I can tell you stories from every corner of the earth.
Yeah, of course.
from Eastern Europe,
with so many different artists as well.
Eastern European countries, Australia, Northern Ireland. We were there when the trouble was going on, yeah. And trust me, I
from early 90s all the way to current. Funny actually sometimes, because when you have parents evening, some of the parents come in and like, oh,
I saw you in
such and so many years ago and blah blah blah. It's quite crazy, but good.
I want to see your hands in the air. Come on, put your hands up. Ow. Are you ready? You know it.
We gigged it for years and years before it was a hit,
yeah.
And it was literally me and five guys in a transit van travelling for petrol money to do the gig.
Sure, he wasn't in Oldham.
No.
First time. Think about it.
Yeah,
think about
I'm thinking
it.
Scotland. Sorry.
Think
He's
about
corrected
it.
Me. Butterflies in Oldham,
yep.
In Lancashire, Manchester.
Yeah. When she was very, very young.
Yeah, still look the same.
Yeah, that's very true, actually.
I do? Yeah.
She does. Looks exactly the same as what she did, like, you know, early 90s.
Yeah.
That change.
21.